Trump aide Cassidy Hutchinson's new memoir, Enough, has disclosed some pretty chilling details about what was happening behind the scenes during the Trump administration. And when it comes to the classified documents case, well, authorities might want to look into Trump's chief of staff, Mark Meadows, because she alleges that Meadows destroyed several documents in the final days of Trump's presidency. Meadows burned so many documents in his fireplace in the final days of the Trump presidency that his wife complained to Hutchinson about how expensive it had become to dry clean the bonfire aroma from his suits. Now, it's unknown what was in the documents that were allegedly destroyed by Mark Meadows, but I have to say it is incredibly frustrating to learn about the details about this and other things that I'm about to share with you through a memoir. You know, years later, when in reality this information should have been reported much earlier, but you know, people have books to sell, so.
Yeah, look, we've talked about this before. 26-year-old writing a memoir is already absurd. Holding these important facts until your book is released is absurd. She's very sensitive about that and says it's super unfair to say that. I don't know why it's unfair. We would all like this information earlier, but okay, fine. It's out now. God bless. And so the most important thing is it credible? And so far, everyone that worked there, with the exception of the people she's actually pointing fingers at and saying they did this wrong and he did that wrong, with those exceptions, all the other women that worked there, etc., are saying, oh yeah, yeah, that's what she's saying is totally true. That's the most important part of this story.
Right.
So Mark Meadows, we still don't know if he turned evidence against Trump in the federal case. And so that's a giant mystery that's hanging out there in the Jack Smith special prosecutor cases, right? But if he did, it's because of stuff like this. Because so many other people that are already cooperating know what Mark Meadows has done. And if Mark Meadows burned a small forest of national secrets and documents, that is, again, outside of the Trump mania, before Trump, whether you're a Republican or a Democrat, if you did any of this, you would have been in a world of trouble. I mean, one of Clinton's guys stuffed like national documents into his socks and stuff and walked out of a facility. And that was a massive federal case, right? And it was like a giant scandal. Meanwhile, Mark Meadows is burning and burning until his wife's like, come on, Mark, you're driving up the dry cleaning bill.
Yeah,
right?
It's crazy.
Let alone what Trump is did at Mar-a-Lago and hiding the top secret documents, etc.
So there's more that we're learning from her book. So she apparently also talked a little bit about just like the unpoliced nature of the White House, even as the Trump administration was super concerned about secrecy. For all its obsession with secrecy, the Trump White House was also strangely unpoliced, she writes, particularly in the waning days of the administration. On January 15th, 2021, Hutchinson encountered Mike Lindell, the conspiracy-minded MyPillow entrepreneur, roaming the building unescorted, declaring, "We can still win." I'm amused by that anecdote. She saw Representative Matt Gaetz, this is super fascinating, a far-right Florida Republican and a Trump ally under federal investigation at the time for sex trafficking, show up without an appointment to lobby Meadows for a pardon. That seems like a pretty big deal. And I remember reporting about that at the time. It is interesting to hear from a White House insider about it. You know, it's published in her memoir, so do with that information what you may. Now, in regard to the criticism she has been getting because she's held on to this information for her book, I think that's legitimate criticism. I totally agree with that criticism. She says that, look, she didn't want to betray her colleagues at the time. I mean, she could have maybe disclosed it after the Trump administration was over, but she didn't. She waited until her book was published. She says that she readily excused Trump's shortcomings, blaming herself and other staffers for his tantrums all the way up to the end of his presidency. She writes that, or yeah, she says, in my mind at the time, I felt like January 6th largely happened because we didn't do enough to stop it. Well, that's definitely true, but again, holding on to some of this like super sensitive information for your book, I think is a huge problem, right? Like we talked about the allegations against Rudy Giuliani sexually assaulting her. I think that information would have been helpful to other women who might fall prey to Rudy Giuliani and his terrible behavior. But in regard to the Mark Meadows story, I mean, you see him burning documents. It seems questionable to you. Okay, you didn't disclose it during the Trump administration. Why wait 2.5 years later to disclose it? It's for your book. We're not dumb. It is what it is. But you know, this isn't, she's not the only one. I know we're being like super harsh with her, but there have been other authors who have done similar things, and it's super frustrating.
Yeah, and but at least she turned, you know, she gave evidence to the January 6th committee, etc. I'm very glad to hear this news because it's relevant to if people did things wrong. And I mentioned the Sandy Berger case where he stuffed the documents into his socks and stuff, because back then Republicans and Democrats were both outraged. And sure, the Democrats defended him a little bit more than the Republicans, of course, right? But overall, people were like, no, this is not even close. This is way, way, way out of bounds. And mainstream media pummeled him. Everybody pummeled him, right? But now everything's partisan. So yeah. Now, like stealing top secret documents, burning top secret documents, all these things, 40% of the country goes, wait, who did it? Was it a Democrat or was it Hunter Biden or was it Donald Trump? Oh, is Trump or Mark Meadows his chief of staff? Then it's totally okay. It's great. Whatever you have top secret documents, you of course you burn them. And in this case, we don't. He burned so many documents. I don't know that any of them were top secret, just to be clear, but classified, right? And then Peter Navarro talks about Cassidy Hutchinson and others, and he's. I mean, if you're a little worried about Cassidy Hutchinson and her timing, that's nothing compared to the goons that stayed there.
Right.
And so look, as you're gonna get to Navarro's, you got it?
I do. Let's talk a little bit about that.
Okay, and then I'll tell you, one last
thing. So remember, Peter Navarro was convicted for contempt of Congress. And so he's super salty about having to suffer the consequences of his behavior. Congress had subpoenaed him to ask questions about January 6th, and he just ignored the subpoena, claiming that he had presidential privilege, which made absolutely no sense in that context. But nonetheless, after this news of Cassidy Hutchinson came out, you know, some of the allegations that were published in her memoir, he got real salty about it. And so he put out a tweet saying, watched Hutchinson in West Wing suck candy daily outside Meadows office doing nothing, pimping new book with White House loser Alyssa Farah. Hutchinson sold soul to January 6th witch hunt. This her next 15 minutes of fame. Rudy Giuliani's a hero, Cassidy trash. So you know where Peter Navarro stands on all of this. And later he wrote, why would White House men, president, VP, senior aide, ever hire a woman after watching book pimps? Cassidy Hutchinson, Alyssa Farah, Stephanie Grisham, Kayleigh McEnany, Olivia Troy, throw mud at Donald Trump, Rudy Giuliani et al. Pimp ladies be given real MAGA women bad name.
What are you, a rapper? What do you mean giving? What is that? What, like, are you cool? Are you tough? Is that what it is?
Well, he is a criminal.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And look at him. I mean, they're not hiding it, guys. He's saying maybe we should never hire women again because they're all pimping. And you know what he actually means. Like, pimping is bad enough, but he's using the word pimp when he's actually referring to something else. And so that's what they think of you. Okay, last question for the Republicans. I know they don't care because detached from logic, but 20% the Rudies, the lunatic Navarro, etc., have stuck around with Trump defending him to the bitter end, right? But over 80% of the people that work for Donald Trump all say, no, maniac, terrible guy, right? And they're all right wingers. Why? Why did all the right wingers say that Trump is a terrible guy, Rudy's a terrible guy? You think they all made it up because of some sort of deep state conspiracy along with Pfizer and you know, and Bill Gates or something? Okay, brothers and sisters, but the much simpler explanation is it's because Trump, Rudy, Navarro, etc. are terrible guys, and you could tell it from their own comments. I mean, who says that about people?
Yeah.
Right? Is that, does that sound like a moral, decent guy to you?
I mean, if you don't want a woman within the administration, you know, spilling the tea, maybe don't get handsy with the women. Maybe don't disrespect them. Maybe don't burn documents and be super suspicious during the administration. But yeah. No, it's the women's fault. It's the women's fault.
Well, was she not supposed to complain? Rudy put his hand up her skirt. Other Republican women confirmed that happened. And Navarro's like, look at her, just she's sucking candy. What the hell is that line? What is that line? And so, oh yeah, you better shut up if we put our hand up your skirt. Otherwise, you're not a real MAGA woman. MAGA woman, you're comfortable with that? Is that what it means to be a real MAGA woman? To let these bastards do that to you? Listen, you do whatever you need to do, but for all sane people, it's obvious who the bad guys are here.
Hey, thanks for watching that video. We really appreciate it, guys. And we appreciate it if you become members, because that allows us to be independent, honest, progressive, all the things that you don't get from corporate media. And all of that is because of you guys. Hit the join button below and become one of us, become a Young Turk.